going to take a tour with Mr. and Mrs. Noell of their chimp farm and let them fill us in on some educational items of the different animals here. Let's take our tour. First stop on the tour is going to be at the Reese Monkey Cage, and this is Mae Noell. She's going to tell us a little bit about the Reese Monkey.
The Reese Monkeys are rhesus monkeys, come from India, and they have a narrow septum between their nose, and that's the way you tell an old world monkey from a new world monkey. A little later we may see some other monkeys and explain the difference between the old and new world. However, the rhesus monkey is very famous for the fact that the name rhesus, R-H-E-S-U-S, is the origin of Rh factor in our blood, and this is the type of monkey that was used so extensively in polio research.
Thank you, Mae. We didn't know that.
They're very interesting little monkeys, but they're just about one of the meanest monkeys in the world for pets.
This is Bob Noell. And Bob, I understand you started quite early in your profession.
I started on the road when I was 12 years old with a medicine show. At first as a blackface comedian, a magician, a ventriloquist, and juggler, and a little bit of everything to entertain the crowd.
You must have thoroughly enjoyed this.
Well, when I was 15, I had my own show. I could entertain the crowd for a couple hours, 3 days a week, three nights a week, worked mostly at night, and different each night, so... Like I tell everybody, I started with nothing, now I got twice that much.
Oh.
So I'm home on, doing better than the government I get.
Truly. You and Mae have been together quite a long time.
Yeah. 52 years now.
You have seen a lot together then.
A lot, a whole lot. Been some rough, some all right, you know. We had some rough times and then some good times too.
Your property, how much acreage do you have here in your property?
With what the son-in-law's got, all of it together, right at 20 acres. So.
That's a lot to keep up.
Yeah, it is. It is. Tax is awful high, too.
And your son-in-law, is he the only one that helps you here?
He does all the work. Well, we've got a couple of volunteers comes in and helps us, too, once in a while. And a fellow by the name of Cook down at the... Lago, he comes up and helps us. And there's not much nobody else could do, you know, you're too close to the animals, they might pull the arm off if they could.
You've had some narrow escapes yourself. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, fingers bit off and hand bit off and teeth knocked out, leg chewed up. I never was hurt with the gorillas, always with the chimps.
Bob, on your of all the animals you've had, do you have one favorite that was sort of just got into your heart? He was just the special one?
Yeah, Tommy was the main one that was a real pet. He got to be that's the ones in the Guinness Book picture, me and him with our back to the camera.
That little pet, I think, was about 600 pounds when
he
left.
That's right.
We're now at the cage of Pete the Chimp. And we're told he is ready to do his famous rain dance for us. Okay, Pete, the stage is yours.
Come on, Pete. Come on, Pete. Play the rain dance. Yeah. Come on, Pete. Come on, Pete. Come on, Pete.
Well, here's Bobby Noell. Bobby, I understand you grew up with some very unusual playmates. Would you tell us a little bit of stories about that? I'm sure you have a lot of them.
There's plenty of stories with my friends that I grew up with. My friends that I grew up with are not like the average people's friends. They were usually in cages, and I was lucky I was outside. Snooky in particular. Me and Snooky were kind of raised up together. Snooky was a chimpanzee, as you well know. Purchased someplace about 39, I believe it was. I'm not sure, 38, 39. And me and Snooky played together and pulled each other in a wagon. And I used to ride him on the back of the bicycle and did many, many things that regular children do, only Snooky was somewhat different. We never held a conversation, and usually Snooky had to go back in the cage at the end of the day, but we had a lot of experiences together that
tell us a little
different.
Bit of what one of them. I know that Snooky did a heroic thing for you one time. Tell us a little
bit
about that.
That's you're probably speaking of the time that I fell in the Mississippi River. We were wintering along the levee under the Huey P. Long Bridge in New Orleans, Louisiana. And that was about 1941, I would guess. And Snooky was tied to a willow tree on a long cow chain. And I had no business going over the levee where Snooky was at because there was no one over there. But I wanted to go over and play with Snooky, and I wound up sliding down a slippery embankment into the Mississippi River. And Snooky gave me his foot to pull me out. I didn't actually tell anyone about that story for like 10 years after it happened because I had no business over there, and I might have got a whipping for going over there. So that was an experience that actually happened, and Snooky was the only thing around to pull me out. And it was scary at the time, but it worked out all right.
Mae, we're in front of the alligator pit, and I understand this alligator is quite a few years old.
Yeah, we have checked over from different people who know where he has been all his life, and he started out as a pup in a pond, and the people fed him and made a pet out of him. And when he got to be too big, they moved him over to Homosassa Springs, where he stayed some 20-odd years, and then he went to Tampa somewhere. And he was there 20-odd years, and by the time they got through checking all of the different places this alligator had been, we figured that he's pushing 100 years awful close. And the game wardens told us that 125 years is the maximum.
He sure looks like a big one.
He has a growth on his tail that a lot of people ask about, and that is a benign tumor, sort of like a mole or a wart, and it hasn't caused him any trouble. However, our original veterinarian that we first started out with told me one day, he says, "Mae, if you'll hold him, I'll operate." So he hasn't had his operation.
Oh, I don't blame you. I wouldn't hold him either.
Incidentally, he must weigh something in the neighborhood of 500 or 600 pounds, and it would be pretty hard to hold anyway.
Mae, you have been on television quite a lot of times, on the radio. You've given many lectures. You've been in the newspaper numerous times, and I'm sure you have page after page after catalog after catalog after books of information and pictures and things of this sort. Show us just a few of those.
Well, this one is of me, and this picture has been in several books that were published around the country and around the world, in fact. That's one picture that has covered the world, and this is another one. This is Tommy with Bob. And it's also on the back of my book that I wrote about the show and the boxing and wrestling chimpanzees. And this picture has gone around the world several times, and it's also in the 1976 issue of the Guinness Book of World Records, just showing how big a gorilla is and not telling whose animal it was. He's actually in that book.
I see. You also wrote a book.
Yes, this one.
This is the book that Mae wrote. The book can only be purchased and found at the Animal Farm in Terrapin Springs. I have read the book, and it's quite fascinating. Mae, Bob has said that there's quite a bit of money put out to feed the animals, to keep the animals here. How do you get the money? Can you give donations? Just how do you go about getting the money together to feed these animals?
We are charging an admission at the Chimp Farm here in Tarpon Springs, and that helps a whole lot. But occasionally people do give donations, and we do have donation boxes around in the place where people can stick a quarter, a dollar, or half a dollar, or whatever they find in their pocket that they don't need.